Hi everyone, I'm Thinlas Chorol from Ladakh in JNK. Ladakh is open for tourism in 1974. Many tourists are coming to Ladakh, and now it's become one of the major income for Ladakhi. Tourism in Ladakh. So Ladakh is famous for many tourists are coming to see monastery, study about the Buddhism, see the mountain view, and many people are coming to trekking, hiking, climbing in the peaks, and many people are coming to see wildlife, flora, fauna, like wildlife, especially in the winter to see snow leopard. In winter, many people are coming to see snow leopard in Ladakh. Like Ladakhi used to be farming society. Both men and female used to stay in the village and used to work equally in the villages. But as soon as start modernization, men are moving out of the village to get income for the families. But mostly stays women in the villages. So then women have to work hard in villages. After tourism opened, very few women get benefit from tourists. Like some women work in the guest house, some women work in the restaurant, some women works as a tour guide, but no one works in a trekking guide. Not because women are weak or generally Ladakhi in the mountain women are very strong and use work as equal, but tourism is new for Ladakhi, so that's why women are not in the trekking industry. Working as a trekking guide around 2000. So when first time I remember I went to one trekking area which is very famous in Ladakh, like Marka Valley. And when I went, there are villages along the trekking route. So they thought I'm a tourist because they haven't seen any female guide. So then I told them, I'm guides, I'm Ladakhi, and start speaking in Ladakhi. So they are very surprised because they told me they haven't seen any female guide. Mostly like men are coming, so they are very surprised to see me in the mountain. When I start trekking, so there are many Ladakhi women who I speak English, they want to become a guide. So they are asking me to trek, you are trekking in the season, can you trek me? And also when I'm trekking the mountain, I meet different clans and many tourists in the mountain. So they're saying, are you guide? Then I'm saying I'm guide. So they are very surprised and they're saying, we've been to many part of Himalaya, we haven't seen any women's trekking guide. We are very happy to see you, and they are very happy. So then later on, I to connect those and also men. When I went to first time with a female tourist, so she told me every year she used to go in Himalaya to trek. So one time she has to cancel her trek because of a male guide. So she told me it's good to do guide. Women also should come in this field. So then in 2009 I started my business to connect those. And I see the people are happy to see female guide, and then there are tourists also needs like who are coming singular women, they need a female guide also. And when I started my business, so that time very few professional guides. Very few professional guides. So then we take every year, every beginning of the season, we take unskilled women who are like strong and who want to become a guide. So they work as a porter in the season. And we also teach English because English is important to communicate with tourists. So then we teach, they work as a porter for whole season. So next season, as soon as when they are working as a porter, they will see what is the challenges, what the guide is doing, all the trekking routes, they will come to know. So as soon as they are confident, we teach about flora, fauna, about monasteries, history of Ladakh, and teach about altitude sickness, or if someone gets injured in the mountain, how to evacuate safely. So we teach all those. And like all women who are working with me are young women, and also sometimes like women who fell in 10, 11, 12, so they want to work in the season. So then sometimes they get a pass in the exam, so some of them drop out because they want to continue their study, and some of them get married, and then some they have to stay in the houses. And some they have baby, so that to improve this, so we'll keep training every year more women. Has the barrier been broken? Before my company, like there was only few travel agencies who has one or two female. Working as a trekking guide. Trekking guide. In 2009, I started my business, which is only employed female guide. Yes, in some way, but there are more than 300 travel agencies in Ladakh. As compared to that, there is not even one person. But there are many travel agencies, they are looking for more female guide. And also they are calling me in the season saying, do you have a female guide? Because they need it. And there are also many other companies, they are asking me to hire female guide. And also like parents, they are asking me to train their daughter to become guide. And also like before 2009, there are a few travel agencies. Now there is like society is changing. I can see like at least society is changing. Parents are not restricting, and no one is saying. Also, other travel agencies are looking for female guides. Thank you for listening.